This is the 8th part of Amazon EKS tutorial. In this lesson, we'll talk about storage and how to run stateful applications in EKS. Now, if you try to deploy a stateful set in EKS right after you provision a cluster, your pods will be stuck in pending state. And if you describe the persistent volume claim, you'll find that the driver or provisioner is missing. To allocate a volume from one of the cloud storage providers, such as EBS, you need to additionally install something called CSI driver. CSI or Container Storage Interface is a Kubernetes extension that allows storage vendors to integrate with Kubernetes. With CSI, storage vendors no longer need to write code in Kubernetes itself. This interface allows them to develop storage plugins independently and deploy those drivers to Kubernetes using Kubernetes primitives, such as Kubernetes pods. One of the most common storage providers people use in AWS and EKS specifically is EBS, Elastic Block Storage. It's one of the cheapest options and very reliable. By default, EKS ships with a default storage class called GP2. You can use it with read-write once access mode, which allowing mounting EBS volume to a single pod. Well, technically it's a single node, but you should only rely on it if you have a specific requirement and have pod affinity property on your stateful set. It's very common to increase the size of the disks for your EC2 instance. For example, when you run a stateful system like Kafka, to allow expansion of EBS volumes attached to Kubernetes nodes, you need to create a custom storage class. I suggest using GP3 storage class and explicitly allowing expansion. In this case, you still won't be able to change the stateful set template because it's immutable property, but in emergency, you can manually edit persistent volume. And in a few seconds, the CSI driver will increase the volume. I use this feature with Prometheus and Thanos deployments. In the following video, we'll use EFS file system. It's elastic, meaning you don't need to manually increase the size, and it supports read-write-many access mode, allowing you to mount it to multiple pods at the same time. Let's go ahead and deploy EBS CSI driver. First of all, we need to create a trust policy, since we'll use EKS pod identities to grant necessary permissions. Then we'll create IAM role using this policy. When it comes to permissions, we can use AWS managed EBS CSI driver policy. It will allow to allocate EBS volumes and attach them to Kubernetes worker nodes. Optionally, if you want to encrypt your EBS volumes, you can create the following IAM policy. I think many companies would like to encrypt their data at rest. Next, we'll attach this encryption policy to our role. And finally, we need to associate this IAM role with Kubernetes service account in kube system namespace. We've done this a couple of times already, so you should be familiar with this process. To deploy, we can use managed EKS add-on. It's pretty much the same as a Helm chart, just wrapped and tested by AWS. The add-on name is AWS EBS CSI driver. You can use a similar command, EKS add-on describe, to get the latest version of this add-on. Alright, let's go ahead and install it. To test, I have prepared a stateful set which will allocate as many persistent volumes as you have replicas. The test is simple. If we can deploy stateful set successfully, it means we have configured everything correctly. Let's try to get the pods. Keep in mind that if you don't deploy CSI driver, all your pods will be stuck in pending state. In this case, it just takes a few seconds to attach a volume to Kubernetes node. Let's get the PVC, which is the persistent volume claim, and it looks like it's already bound. Let's describe it to make sure it was successfully allocated. These are pretty much the same steps you would follow if your pod is stuck in pending state. Alright, we just verified that we can run stateful applications using CSI driver. The next section will cover how to use EFS Elastic File System, which you can mount to multiple pods at the same time with read-write-many access mode.